Hey guys, welcome to my kitchen and welcome, wait, I'm Nikki Sizemore. I forgot to introduce myself. Hey guys, I'm Nikki Sizemore. Welcome to my kitchen and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you a recipe that is a staple in my house for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. I'm going to show you how to make my easy gluten-free crepes recipe. So whether you say crepes or crepes, they're essentially thin French pancakes. And this version, you guys, this version is foolproof. We're going to use gluten-free flour today to make gluten-free crepes. However, if you can eat gluten, you can follow this exact same recipe using all-purpose flour and just make regular crepes. These crepes are so delicious. They've got that lacy, crispy edge, that tender center. I'm gonna show you all of my easy tips and techniques. I'm also going to show you how I love to serve these crepes. I've got both some sweet and some savory ideas to share with you. I can't wait to show you how to make this easy gluten-free crepes recipe, so let's head to the kitchen. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button below, that way you won't miss out on any of my wholesome, family-friendly, and naturally gluten-free recipes. This easy batter gets made right in a blender, and we're going to start with the gluten-free flour. I've tested a ton of different gluten-free flours, and I'll list my favorites below. Next, we have sugar. That's going to help with the flavor as well as browning. A touch of salt, whole milk, or for a dairy-free version, you could use a nut milk or soy milk, and 4 large eggs. Just pop the lid on and we're gonna blend this up until smooth. If you need to, stop and scrape those sides a few times just to make sure that those little pockets of flour get incorporated. We are blending this batter instead of whisking it because we want a really smooth batter. That's going to give us nice thin pancakes. Last but not least, I'm adding some melted butter that's going to create tender crepes and also provide more flavor. That's it. We need to let this batter rest in the refrigerator for 30 minutes, or you can let it rest for up to 1 day. I like to pour it into another container, but you can actually just leave it in the blender container if you prefer. When you are ready to cook your crepes, give the batter a quick whisk. Then we're going to preheat a 10-inch non-stick skillet with 1 teaspoon of vegetable oil. Preheating the skillet is going to give us really even, consistent browning. Wipe that oil all over the bottom of the pan, increase the heat to medium, and now we're going to add the batter. Spoon about 1/3 cup of the batter into the pan while swirling. Takes a bit of practice, but I promise you can get it. Once the bottom is brown and crispy, use your fingers and just flip that crepe over. It only needs about 15 to 30 seconds on the other side. Let me show you again how you do this. So you swirl in that crepe batter while swirling the pan at the same time. Once those edges are browned and crispy, loosen them up and then use your fingers and give the crepe a flip. Now don't worry if your crepe isn't perfectly round on the first try. I promise it'll still taste delicious. As the crepes finish cooking, just layer them onto a cooling rack and then let them cool completely. Now for the fun part, let me show you some of my favorite ways to serve these perfect gluten-free French crepes. For an easy but scrumptious breakfast or dessert, spread the crepes with fruit jam, add whipped cream and fresh berries or sliced fruit. For a savory version, layer on ham and cheese, or go for dessert with chopped dark chocolate. Just fold these up and bake them until the filling is melted and the crepes are warmed through. These ham and cheese crepes are one of my favorite lunches and dinners, but you could go for scrambled eggs or smoked salmon. The options are endless. Now for those chocolate crepes, I like to drizzle them with a little bit more melted chocolate and then dollop them with whipped cream or top them with a scoop of ice cream. This is the ultimate dessert. And for a simple version, layer on a little bit of butter, some fresh lemon juice and sugar, warm these through and then serve them with powdered sugar on top. This is actually my kids' favorite way to eat crepes.
Thank you guys so much for tuning in. I hope you feel empowered to give this easy gluten-free crepe recipe a try. And stay tuned because next week we are going to transform these crepes into a show-stopping dessert. I've included a link below to the full recipe, and I've also included a link to my website where you can find a ton of other holiday recipes and everyday recipes. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you next time.